see you. Welcome to the sign up. It is a extensive process, but we will get there. First off, seeing as this is Dr. Frankenstein's bodybuilding competition, are you aware that this is in fact a bodybuilding competition and not a strongman competition? Yes, we are quite literally building bodies. Correct? That's correct. Great. Well, we can go ahead and get started if you are ready to proceed. Right, this is an extensive process, so I hope you have a bit of time. Okay. Great. Well, seeing as the contest is, it's in two parts. There is a doctor expo and the bio that will be said before your creation and or monster is presented. So for that bio, a quick little snippet about yourself, we will be needing some personal information in order to create that bio. Are you ready to proceed doing that? Great. All right, it's just a couple questions for the bio portion. We will be needing the name of the first school that you ever attended, the name of your first pet, your mother's maiden name, your favorite color, and the street you grew up on. That's correct. Yes, it will remain confidential, but we'll go ahead and apply to the bio that we will be providing for the expo. Yes. Great. All right. What is your mother's maiden name? Great. Is that with an E? Can you confirm the spelling? Okay, that's an interesting name. Could you go ahead and give me the street you grew up on? Okay. And can you confirm the spelling on that? What was the name of the first school that you attended? Okay, could I get the name of your very first pet? Yes, very first pet you ever had. Great. Is that with an E? It is. Okay, great. Could I get the name of your favorite teacher? Your favorite teacher. Great. Is that with an E? That is with an E. Excellent. Perfect. Let's go ahead and talk about, your father's middle name. Yes, your father's middle name. Just his middle name. Great. All right. It looks like, we have all of that information for the bio. All right, now we'll need to take down some information that will pertain to just the registration in general. Correct. All right, how do you spell your first name? All right. Excellent. And your middle name? Great. Oh, excellent. What is your surname? Correct. Wonderful. A beautiful name. The next portion. All right. What is your address? Yes, your address. Your current your home address. If you have a different mailing address, we can take that. You do have a P.O. box. Very smart. It's a lot easier to ship and receive the various goods that you would need for bodybuilding. And typically you don't want your neighbors to see that, right? I wouldn't either. Let's take your home address. And that's Lane. Lane, excellent. City and state? Wonderful. Absolutely wonderful. I believe Dr. Frankenstein himself had visited there. He said it was lovely. He said it was lovely. But then again, he says a lot of things. What is the zip code? The zip code? Yes, the zip code. Great. Alright, and what is your P.O. box? Excellent. Excellent. And is that the same city and state? It's different. That's probably a wise idea. Many of our young creators do not recognize this. Wonderful. And that is where you primarily ship and receive your goods for bodybuilding. This is important to note. I will make a note of that. Excellent. That will factor into the judging process, as we do take initiative and drive quite seriously in the decision. That is correct. Okay. Okay. Very well. Excellent. Are there any selling points that you would like to give to the judges beyond the build, the basic build of your creation? The basic elevator pitch, per se. Okay. 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 All right. Okay. Okay. Okay, that way, but you're not me, so that's interesting. Great. Before we continue on to the discussion of your build and the name, make, and model of your build, we will, in fact, need to reiterate that the terms and conditions need to apply. We need to make sure that you are cognizant of the terms and conditions. You're aware of them, correct? You are aware of them. You're aware they exist, that's correct? You're aware of them. Are you aware of them? You know they exist. Oh, you are aware, though. Yes. What are the terms and conditions? It's not important. But you are aware of them. I will make a note of that. Alright, are you ready to proceed to sign the rights to your creation? Yes, the rights to your creation. Yes, effectively, if you do win this competition, Dr. Frankenstein Incorporated will own your creation. Yes. The blueprint, the model, the graveyards in which you sourced the materials from. It will all be like it was our idea, yes. That is correct. Correct. It will be ours. Are you ready to sign away those rights? Excellent. Let's go ahead. Can you go ahead and... can you sign right here? It won't take too long. Can you go ahead and, can you sign right here? Yes. Okay, right. I'll do it for you. Excellent. Wonderful. Well, that looks like all of the personal information that we'll need to have. Beyond your personal documents, your social security card, any credit cards that you will be using during the exhibition, during the buying and selling of goods at the vendors outside of the contest, we will need your credit card information. And what is the number of that? And this is your debit card. What's the routing number? The routing number, yes. Excellent. Great. Thank you. This is important information. All right. Now we'll need to go ahead and get the last little, those little three digits on the back of the card. Do you have those? Excellent. Great. And what is the primary credit card you will be using at these vendors? Great, okay. What are those three little digits on the back? Excellent. Oh, this is standard routine, it's fine. Great, okay. It looks like we have all of your personal information. We can go ahead and get to the, we can get to the discussion of the creation that you have made. Oh, we will love to hear your ideas and take them. Great. Alright, what is the, name of your creation? Your monster, your build, your creation, your monster. Okay, now that's unique. Dr. Frankenstein himself named his monster Dr. Frankenstein's monster. I think that's very silly. No unique name. But he is the creator of this contest, so What am I to say? It's just my opinion, though. Frankenstein's monster. It's so vague, right? People get confused a lot. Oh, a lot. They think that Frankenstein is the name of the monster. Yes, I just think it's very silly. Great. Excellent. Alright, where did you source your materials? Which graveyards did you pluck those little body parts from? Excellent. So that's a total of 30 graveyards you had visited. That's quite a small amount. And all are these locally sourced body parts? All organic, formaldehyde free, correct? Excellent. Are there any additives or preservatives within your build? Is it gluten free? Excellent. See, this will factor into the judging process when we steal your idea, when we take your ideas. Excellent. Oh, that's great. Oh, yes, absolutely. Oh, positively, yes, absolutely. Great. Okay, could I get the names and addresses of the graveyards in which you sourced these body parts? Great, okay. So the first one is a lovely place. Like we're gonna go all the way up to 30 graveyards if you are prepared to share the names and addresses of those locations. Yes, and for the 30 graveyards, we will also be needing to know the grave diggers' names, who assisted with any or all exhumations. Oh, you did it yourself? This also factors into our judging process. We do take initiative and drive very seriously. That's correct. Wonderful, okay. What's the name of the second one again? I don't think I wrote that down. The second graveyard, yes, the second graveyard. And the third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, and then the eighth, ninth, tenth, great. Graveyard 11. Lovely, lovely. I love that place. Is it wrong to say that it has a little bit of life to it? I don't know. It just has this little spark. Maybe it's because so many of our creators create life from that specific graveyard. Good for them. Good for them. 12. 13, 14, and then 15. Now that's the same one as the 8th. Do you want to revise the 8th, or okay? I believe we're on 15. Is that correct? 15. 18, and then the 19th. Okay. Twentieth. 21st. first. 22, 23. The 24th graveyard. Excellent. 25? Right, okay. 26. 27. 28th. 29th. Oh yes, lovely place. And then the 30th. Great. Excellent. Wonderful. If you'd like to go ahead and share all those personal documents with us, we would love to see it. Wonderful. Yes. Your birth certificate, your creation's birth certificate. Both are needed for the entry to the contest. Yes. That's correct. Well, it looks like you're good to go. You're good to go. Thank you so much for sharing with me. I look forward to seeing you at the contest. Yes. I think you'll go far. Yes, you'll do great. Wonderful. All right, you have a good one. Bye-bye.